in some of the previous videos, I was asked as to what is it that I keep adding into the water like this. So I thought, why not explain the whole system behind this? What is NPK fertilizer and why I mix it into water? How I made powder into liquid? Let me be very frank in saying that this is a poor man's solution. This is not the ideal situation. See, the plants require micro and macronutrients, and in macro also, NPK is just one half of it. The other half is calcium, magnesium and sulphur, I think. So that is missing in this. So this is the bare minimum that is required for the plant to survive. And when I'm in such small pots where the medium is just sand, there is no nutrition in the sand, I have to feed it externally. And with just NPK, this has given me this kind of a growth. So imagine the growth if it was a proper well-balanced macro and micronutrients that was being given. So what I recommend is that you buy the best macro and micronutrient liquid fertilizer from a hydroponic shop or store. I do not know the brands, and I don't have the expertise to give you tips on that. But I know that is where I have to go. These are all short-term solutions, a poor man's solutions. You need to invest in a good hydroponic macro and micronutrient solution. So I'll be covering some of the things that I've forgotten to mention in my previous videos, because some people pointed it out and I'm glad they did. So in case you feel something is missing in my video where it is not very clear as to what happened, what I did, please feel free to add it in the comments and I can clarify there. Or in my next video I'll be more careful as to what is being explained, because the way I do it, some of the things are obvious to me and it may not be obvious to the casual viewer. This is the NPK fertilizer which I got from market. It is a small packet of fertilizer. And the strength is 20, 20, 20. That is, nitrogen is 20, phosphorus is 20 and potassium is 20. Now this is a very high strength. I don't advise you to buy such high strength fertilizer. I bought it in my ignorance. You need something more like 10, 10 or 10, 10, 10 or less. A little bit of this was put into a smaller container for easier handling. So my goal is to prepare one bottle of concentrated liquid fertilizer of NPK. So I take the water first, the required amount in a bottle like this, and then empty it into this glass. And next I take NPK powder and granules. So I just take 1 teaspoon, that's it, and add to this. This job is done. Now I use a handle of an old paintbrush. So the advantage of this is, this end is flat and this helps me in crushing the granules. So stir it nicely. Every time I stir this, the water becomes very muddy and I allow it to settle down for some time and the water to become clear, so I can see how many more granules need to be powdered. And I powder them like this and start stirring it up again. So this is repeated a few times during the day, and then I left the water to completely settle down overnight. And now I assume the water is completely saturated with the fertilizer. It's ready to be bottled into this. Let me show you the top view of this. That's how it looks. My goal is to get this water into the bottle, but this rim is too wide and the water will drip down. So I want to move this to another container first. my bottle of concentrated NPK fertilizer liquid is ready. It was prepared by dissolving this solid powder in granules, and it took about a day to do this. And as I said, this is very strong. It's 20-20-20, and if you put this directly, it will burn the plant's roots and they will die. They will shed leaves and they will die. And I have experienced it personally. So I'm telling you, do not buy something this strong. And since it is already strong, I'm diluting it. This is just 1 teaspoon of this powder. And this is distributed for several plants, not just one pot or plant. I just want to give you some secret tips. These are chemicals and they're strong. Wash your hands thoroughly after handling these things. And I want to tell you that this is not a drinking glass. This is a container for liquid chocolate. So that came in this, we're just having a wrapper on top. I have thoroughly rinsed and cleaned this just now. Because if you forget this and next time you add water and put a cutting in this, disasters will happen. It will be too strong and they will create all kinds of issues or even kill the plant. When using water bottles and soft drink bottles in these kind of setups, always make sure you have a label which says clearly what the content is. Because they look like something else, kids can easily mistake it and drink it. And you do not want that kind of situation to happen. I have an 8-year-old son who knows what I'm doing and that these things contain stuff that is not drinkable. But he might have a friend who comes home and accidentally intake this. Or in my absence, there might be a smaller kid in the house, a neighbor's kid who might come and take this in, and it can lead to a very unfortunate situation. So please consider safety all the time, especially when kids are around. Things can go wrong and I don't want any unfortunate thing happening. And let me be very clear in giving a disclaimer. I am merely sharing my experience. It need not be the best method. I do not accept any responsibility for your positive or negative experiences arising out of my videos. So please, let's be very clear on that. So this is a 1/2 liter bottle of water, just tap water. And I'm pouring 1 cap of my concentrated NPK fertilizer. And just pour it into this. Now this cap has one single tiny hole. So this is my squeeze bottle. I close this with my finger and give it a nice shake. Let me show you how I water the hybrid-ponic setup. So I water this top pot separately once or twice a day depending on how hot the day is. And as the water level starts dipping down, I make sure it is maintained at the same height. Now it is possible for the new roots to emerge from this pot and actually jump that barrier of air and dip into the water. They have no problems doing that. If the gap is too much, the new roots might hesitate to come out because there is a moisture loss happening from this gap over here. So, and I was asked in another video of this rain tree video whether there is any need for pruning these roots. Yes, there is a strong need, because if I don't do this, what happens is, imagine the first taproot comes out and it goes into water. And if I'm lucky, it might have side branches, but that is one single root going into the water. I do not want that. I want multiple roots from here. So several times when the new roots emerge into sand tray kept beneath this, they were pruned off. And hence I started seeing multiple roots from multiple holes come out. If you can see, there are fresh roots emerging. So these roots are not in contact with the water. They're hanging into air, but they know there is a high moisture content available down below and they are heading towards that. This is exactly going as per my design and plan. And
I love this thick, it's so thick, unbelievably thick. So this is watered separately like this, I mean the fertilized separately like this, and the soil is done separately. Now if you do not want to water such a tiny pot on your own, so let's say you are going away for a while, a good idea to convert this into a self-watering setup is use twine. So this is just a cotton twine. I can cut a small strip of this and put it inside the sand and make sure it comes out from below the holes and dips into water. So this itself becomes like a root and it's drawing water up into the sand. So this way then I don't have to water this area separately. I just make sure this tank is full. Now this is a water bonsai. It's a ficus racemosa. This cutting was rooted in water and has developed branches and leaves completely in water. So if I were to change the water for this, what I do is hold the trunk properly and lift this cardboard opening, pour out the liquid completely. And take this using the squeeze bottle. I'm actually replacing the water, and this is fertilized water.